Welcome back to Sister Circle Live. If you, like most of us, probably don't need an excuse to partake in the simple pleasures of enjoying a glass of wine, our next guest is the founder of a wine tasting company called Shall We Wine.
And I say, yes, we shall.
Hello, somebody.
So please welcome sommelier and author of Searching for Cloves and Lilies, the wine edition, Miss Regine Rousseau. How are you?
Yay! Thank you for having me.
It's always great to have you. Now, let's start off by asking, what is a sommelier?
Okay, sommelier is someone who is certified to teach, serve, educate about wine. So that's what it is. So you have to attend an institution that gives you a certification. I attended the International Sommelier Guild, and I have my level 2 certification.
So then, how do we get right on into the wine?
I know that's right.
You know, that's what I'm
looking at. Right, okay. So I brought you a bunch of deliciousness today.
Yes.
So fall wines, these are some of my favorites. And I brought you, this one looks strange, doesn't it?
It does. It has like a cloudy,
unfiltered look.
Oh, look! Oh! It is unfiltered.
Yes,
it's wine connoisseur.
I know. So this is an orange wine, and one of the reasons I love it for the fall is the color, right? But there's a spiciness to it, and I love it with with root vegetables, which I tend to eat a lot in the fall. And I think the fish dish that was served last night would have been perfect with this.
Quad fish dish.
Yes.
Quad fish dish. Yes. Now, while we sip this, tell us the logic behind when you sip and spit.
Okay. So when you're a sommelier and you're doing your training, sometimes we have to taste 30, 50 wines. You don't want to take in all that alcohol. So you swirl it around to taste the wine, to get the essence of the wine, but then you spit it out so that you can continue, you can keep going.
Right, because after 30, it can get weird.
You know what? After 10, it gets really weird.
Really, after 10, it can get different. Yeah.
So the next one I have for you is the Conundrum. Conundrum is a blend of about 5 different white grapes. There's Chardonnay, there's Viognier, there's Muscat de Canelli in it. Love this wine for the fall, especially for Atlanta, because y'all want to get Chicago cold, but you want a white wine with a little bit more oomph to it. And this is not a sweet wine, but there's a little bit of sweetness, so that if you're doing something spicy or you're having brunch, this wine is delicious.
And how did you come up with Shall We Wine?
You know what? I surveyed 100 friends, and I had a list of names, and I said, which name do you like? And the majority picked Shall We Wine, but that's perfect because that's what I do. I invite people to wine. Everything with me is about exploration. You don't have to be an expert, you just have to explore. Speaking of exploring, let's try the Pinot Noir.
And I love a good Pinot Noir.
They say this is
the thinnest grape, is that true?
It is a thin skin grape, it is. So this is Andre Houston Mack, who's an African-American winemaker. I love this because it's called OPP. Well, you know me. So in my book, I have this wine and I pair it with a poem called That Brother They Call D.
Tell us a little bit about your book.
Yes, okay, so my book is a book of poetry. And I pair the poems with wines. And my whole goal, thank you, because I want to teach people how to have fun with wine, how to explore wine, and how to understand the mood and the story of wine.
Yes.
So each poem has a wine that really echoes the mood of it.
That's
so
awesome.
Thank you. And I'm here tonight at City Winery doing a wine tasting and poetry reading.
Oh, nice.
So come out and see me. And you gotta taste the last one.
I like the glass already.
Great.
This glass is my style.
This is the first wine that I feature in the book, okay?
Ooh, this smells.
I can't wait to have some. I know. See, I almost did the wine dance. Okay, so you know how we talk about comfort food, right? Well, there's something called comfort wine, too. This is the kind of wine that's gonna hold your hand. It's going to kiss you on the back of the neck. The kind of wine that's going to give you a hug.
Oh, it's almost like a man.
Yes.
Yes.
Amazing. So I have an extra bottle.
Oh, you have an extra? Okay, yes.
Okay, I got you, ladies.
Thank you. What would you like for me to
come right on in with?
This is Chateau Mussard.
Look, this is the one that would go with your fish.
It's from Lebanon.
Is this a blend? What is this?
Yes, it's Cabernet and a grape called Sans Salt.
This one, for me, is my favorite.
It's beautiful.
And this Pinot Noir is very good as well.
You brought these wines in here like this, tasting this fabulous.
Yes, she did.
My God.
Yes, she did.
What is this one that I'm having here?
This is a Chateau Mussard. It's actually one of my favorite wines. It is here in the Atlanta market, right?
Yeah.
It is the first wine in my book because when I tasted it, I was like blown away.
It's unbelievable.
Yes. It is.
And
it's so gratifying. Did you try it?
It smells better than it's tasting.
Yummy. They want us, everybody get your glass so we can
share. I just stole this from Selena.
Yes. To Regine, thank you so much.
You're welcome.
Fabulous.
You're welcome.
Wait a minute. There you go.
There you go. All right. Cheers.
Cheers. Success of your company and everything.
Yes. You know what? Regine, we thank you so much for being with us. We learned so much about wine today. And if you happen to be in Atlanta, please join her this evening for Wine and Words at the City Winery. And up next, we hear from you and what the people say.
They said the wine was good.
That's what they said. They said Jesus kept the party going.
Yeah.